Hello students, welcome to today's session of online class of Sri Gokulam Public School Guruvayur. Children, today we are going to discuss about chapter 5, that is cash flow statement. In our previous class we have discussed about three main activities related to cash flow statement. They were operating activity, investing activity and financing activity. We also discussed the format related to cash flow statement. We did a problem in which operating activity, cash flow of operating activity was discussed. Today, let us do the problem where all the three activities are involved. Okay. So, you can take your book and a pencil, pen, everything with you. We are going to discuss illustration 56 of your book. Here you are given a balance sheet in this question of Thermal Power Limited as on 31st March 2014. Okay. So you can see here there are two amounts which is given to you, 2014 and 2013. 2013 is the previous year. We can also call it as opening year. Okay, and 2014 is the current year, or we can call it as closing year. Clear? Here is a balance sheet with equity and liability and asset side or asset items. In equity and liability, you know that there are items like shareholders fund and non-current liabilities and current liabilities. And in asset, you have non-current asset and current asset. Notes to account is also provided to you, in which three items are here of reserves and surplus, and we have intangible assets, tangible assets as well as intangible assets. So those items are provided as notes to account at the bottom. In addition to that, you have additional information also. During the year, a piece of machinery costing ₹24,000, on which accumulated depreciation was ₹16,000, was sold for ₹6,000. So this is the additional information given to you. So children, what you have to understand over here is, in the question, if you have additional information related to sale of any machinery and also accumulated depreciation is provided to you, in that case, one more item should be given to you, that is machinery account opening and closing balance and accumulated depreciation account opening and closing balance. In such a case, what you have to do is you have to prepare an account. So, did you understand what I told you? You have to check out whether machinery opening and closing balance is given to you, accumulated depreciation closing and opening balance is given to you, plus in additional information, you are provided with sale of machinery and accumulated depreciation information is provided. In that case, you have to prepare an account. Which account you will prepare? Machinery account and accumulated depreciation account. So, you have to prepare two accounts. Okay. So, that will be the working note you have to prepare in this case. Already you are preparing a working note for calculation of net profit before tax and extraordinary item. In addition to that, you have to prepare machinery account and accumulated depreciation account. So children, before that, you have to see this, you have to understand that machinery is an asset. So machinery is an asset, so it have a debit balance. So on the debit side of machinery account, you have to write to balance brought down. So brought down amount means the previous amount. So 10 lakh on the debit side, you have to write to balance brought down. And on the credit side, you can write by balance carried down with 12,70,000. This was about machinery. What about accumulated depreciation? As this is a liability, provision is a liability, so this will be record, the balance of liability side is credit balance. So on the credit side, you have to write, on the credit side of accumulated depreciation, you will write by balance brought down with 1,50,000 and to balance carried down with 2 lakh. Let us check out what is given over here. You can see here machinery account to balance brought down 10 lakh. Leave some space, and at the end of that you can write by balance carried down with 12,70,000. This is given in the question. Okay. Now regarding accumulated depreciation, being a liability, it will have a credit balance. So the credit balance of accumulated depreciation, you will write this way: by balance brought down 1,50,000 and to balance carried down with 2 lakh. Okay. So what we discussed in the earlier slide, that the same thing we have done over here. What next? The next information provided to you is, during a year, a piece of machinery. So out of this machinery, with you is, in the beginning is 10 lakh. Out of this 10 lakh, there was a machinery costing rupees 24,000. That machinery they are selling after the accumulated depreciation of 16,000, they are selling it for 6,000. So let me show you a working note for doing this. The original cost of machinery, the original or the cost value of the machinery which we are going to sell is 24,000. It is given in the question that the machinery which we are going to sell, its original cost is 24,000. After charging the depreciation on that machinery, which is also given to you in the question with 16,000, what you receive is 8,000. So 24,000 less 16,000, you will get 8,000. That is the book value. That is called as the book value of that machinery. On that, the sales value. So it is sold. It is mentioned in the question that this machinery sold for 6,000. So sales value less sales value. From the book value, you will less the sales value. What you will receive is the loss on sales. See children, 8,000 is the value of that machinery after charging the depreciation. You sold that machinery for 6,000. So 8,000 item you are selling for 6,000, that means it's a loss for you, isn't it? So that loss. Now what you have to understand is, from this working note, many items are there which you are going to pass in your books or account. The first thing is the loss. Okay, after selling this machinery, what is your loss that you have to transfer? Then for what value you are selling this machinery, that also you have to transfer, plus the accumulated depreciation on that machinery, that. So these three items you have to show in this particular account. See, accumulated depreciation of 16,000 I have recorded over here. Then loss on sale of machinery have recorded over here, and after selling this item, you are selling actually this item for sales, and you receive cash for 6,000. So these three items I have shown in my machinery account. Okay, I got that from that working note. Okay, so sales value is 6,000, depreciation on that machinery is 16,000, and it was sold at a loss of 2,000. So children, I got all the items being written over here. Now, when I close this account, I can find a shortage of, that is, the debit balance is short by 2,94,000. Okay, that I will write as to bank account, and I will show as purchase of machinery. Do you understood? So when I close machinery account, my credit side is more than my debit side. My debit side is short by 2,44,000. 2,94,000. So that I have to write as to bank account, and I will write it as a purchase of machinery. Okay. That was a balancing figure. Now what about accumulated depreciation? We have already passed balance brought down on carry down. Accumulated depreciation on the machinery which we have sold, that I have to pass over here. So 16,000 I got from the working note, last working note. So credit aspect I have recorded. I recorded the debit aspect of the same. So machinery account, from this machinery account I brought this accumulated depreciation of 16,000. Now let us close accumulated depreciation account too. When I closed this account, my debit side was 2,16,000, but credit side is short. This side I got only 1,50,000. So what I will do? The short on credit side is for 66,000. This is the depreciation on the remaining machinery. So children, I have sold only some part of my machinery. For that, I got the accumulated depreciation as 16,000. What about the rest of the machinery? On rest of the machinery, the depreciation is also charged. Every year we charge depreciation. So on the rest of machinery, the depreciation charge is 66,000. After showing this working note, I got that amount. 66,000. I hope you understood the preparation of machinery account. Next, let us move to the working of cash flow statement. So children, cash flow from operating activity. As you know, the net profit before tax and extraordinary item, we prepare a working note, right? So in that working note, we have net profit as a statement of profit and loss account, closing minus opening. Then we add some items. But in our question, none of the item is given. See, in general reserve, there is only one item which we have to pass, that is surplus. Surplus, what are we supposed to do as per that formula? Closing balance minus opening balance. So 3 lakh minus 2 lakh, 1 lakh is the amount of profit that we have to transfer in the amount. So see, 1 lakh. Okay, closing balance minus opening balance. So 1 lakh I got. Now there is no interim dividend given in the question, no proposed dividend, nor the tax. Nothing is mentioned in this question. If you go through this question, nothing, no other item is given. Only the surplus, that is closing and opening balance, given in the question. So only that item we will use for the working note. Because only one item is there, so I didn't go for a lengthy working note. Instead, they have shown that working note in here itself. Okay, so 1 lakh I got as net profit before tax and extraordinary item. What next? Here are some items which we have to add. Okay, so that items are known as non-cash expenses, or also known by non-operating expenses. So see children, depreciation on machinery. We got depreciation. How much is the depreciation on whole machinery? See, don't take the accumulated depreciation. You have to take the depreciation which is charged on the other machinery. It is 66,000. So note it. Okay, make it an important point and note down that 66,000 is the depreciation which you have to wrote over here. When you sold this machinery, it was sold on the loss. So in your format, if you have studied the format thoroughly, you can understand that loss on sale of machinery, you will add over here. After calculation, if it is a profit, what you will do? You will subtract it. Okay? You will subtract it. Now what next? See, if you move back to the format, you can understand that here there is a goodwill. Goodwill is an intangible asset. So here you can see that the previous year goodwill was 1,12,000. And now what happened in 2014? Its value is decreased. So, if there is decrease in the value of goodwill or intangible asset, it is known as amortization. So, you have studied in the format that goodwill, if amortized, will be recorded on the as a non-cash items. So, the difference between that value will be written over here. Remember, difference only minus closing balance minus opening balance, the difference item. Sorry, opening balance minus closing balance, that difference. So, as per the formula, we have added all the items which are given in the questions. And now, next, less items. So, children, if you look into the questions, there is no rental income, no items which items interest income, or no items are there which we have to subtract. So that means there is no cash income related items in your questions. So if there is no items to be subtracted, then just leave it. Okay, so our working note for that part, what is given to you in the question, till that only you have to add. So no items is there for non-cash income. You have three items for non-cash expenses, but no items in non-cash income. So leave it. Only with the what is there in your question, you will add and subtract those items. So these three items you will subtract from the net profit before tax and extraordinary items. So the amount what you will receive is 2,40,000. That is the operating profit before working capital changes. Okay, operating profit before working capital changes is 2,40,000. Now what next? As per the format, next is calculation of you have to subtract increase in current asset and decrease in current liabilities. And if there is increase in liability and decrease in asset, that have to be added. But if you look into the question, you can see that current liability, there is only one item, that is trade payables. And trade payable in previous year is 2,04,000, and it have decreased to 1,74,000. The difference between these two you have to take to the there is decrease in current liability. So decrease in current liability means, as per your format, you have to subtract it. Okay, you can write your trade payables. The difference between that 2 year is 25,000. Okay, now next items, as per your list you can see short term provision. So short term provision, in the previous year it was 77,000, and now it came to be 50,000. Okay, so there is decrease in the provision, there is decrease in your current liability. So that difference of decrease you will show same as trade payables. You should show it in the less side, that is short term provision. The difference about between the amount is 27,000, right? Now what about after finishing that, what you have to do is look into the current asset list. So current liability is over. Now what about current liability assets? In current asset, there is only you can see here are three items: current investments, inventories, and trade receivables. So what about current investments? Current investment, it is given to you that it is 1,50,000, and there is increase in current investment to 2,40,000. So whenever there is increase in current asset, you have to decrease it. So less it, as per the format, increase in current asset, you have to subtract it. So children, our current liability list is over. Now look into the list of current liability. Both the items are transferred. Now what about the list of current asset? You have four items, but all the four items will not go to the that list. Why? Because as per our format, current investment is an item of cash and cash equivalent, as well as you have also one cash and cash equivalent. So as per this form, as per the format of cash flow, these two items will go to cash and cash equivalent. So only two items are there related to current asset, which will go to the that particular working note. So see, inventories, what happened to inventories? It was 1,21,000, and in the current year it increased to 1,29,000. So increase in current asset, as per the format, what are you supposed to do? Subtract it. So inventories you can write, and the difference between the amount, that is 8,000, you can write over here. Okay, now next item is trade receivables. If you check out your current asset, the second item is trade receivables. The difference, see, 1,43,000 is the amount given in 2013, and you look into 2014, what happened to current trade receivables? It have increased, isn't it? So as per the format, increase in trade receivables or current asset, you have to subtract it. So the difference between this 1,70,000 and 1,43,000, the difference is of amount 27,000. So that will be written over here. Here you write trade receivables. Okay. So our items related to that is increase in current asset and decrease in current liability is all done. Now all these items will be added together over here. Then this 2,40,000, from that you subtract 87,000. Children, subtract this amount of 87,000. If I am putting it in the bracket, understand it is a subtraction. Okay, 2,40,000 less 87,000, you will get 1,53,000. As your cash flow from, see if your answer is in positive, you can see your answer is it is in positive. So 1,53,000 is it is in positive. So you have to use the word from, cash flow from operating activity. Okay, if your answer you are getting after add subtracting all, you if you are getting in minus, then what you will write? Cash flow or cash used in operating activity. So cash flow from operating activity is over. Now let us see what to do with investing activity. So when you are doing the investing activity, you have to look into your so children, when you are doing the investing activity, you have to look into the fixed assets. So check out you in your tangible, there is both tangible and intangible asset. In tangible asset, you have only one item, that is machinery. Okay, in working note, it is given that machinery is the only item. So for machinery, you have prepared one account, right? So in from that, you can get the detail about the machinery. So you got the detail that you have sold some machinery and you have purchased some machinery. That is the investment you have made during the year. Okay, so that amount you have to write over here. You can see here, purchase of machinery is of 2,93,000, that you can write over here. Why it is put in bracket? Because when you purchase a machinery, there is cash outflow. Cash is moving out. That's why it is given in minus. So putting a bracket means minus. And there is also one purchase of machinery. Sale of machinery. So when you are selling a machinery, you receive the cash. So 6,000 will be put added over here. Okay, it is added. So sale of machinery and purchase of machinery are the two items which will come under investing activity. Okay. So see, intangible asset, what happened? Well, there is only one intangible asset, that is goodwill. But you can notice it is a decrease in goodwill. So decrease in goodwill means what? You have to write off. If increase in goodwill, then you have to put it in the investing activity. Okay, so we have only one item intangible asset, and that is machinery. So we have prepared an account, that's why we put a purchase and sale of that machinery in that particular account. If that account is not prepared, then what you will do? The difference between the closing and opening you have to do. And if there is an increase in machinery, then that will be a purchase. And if there is decrease in machinery, then it will be a sales. Okay, so according to you, according to that, you have to proceed. If not, given a adjustment. Now what next? So your investing activity is also over. Only two items were there. So you from this purchase, you subtracted the 6,000 and you got 2,88,000. So you got the amount in negative. You can see I have put it in a negative. So if it is a negative, what is the usage? It's use cash used in investing activity. I hope you understood it. Okay. Now third activity is cash flow from financing activity. So children, if cash flow in financing activity is there, where are you supposed to check that financing activity? It is the cash, that is share capital, you have to look into, and long-term borrowings you have to look into. Okay. So in the question, you can see share capital. It was 11 lakh. Now it came to 12 lakh. So what is there? There is increase in your share capital. So what may the reason of increase in share capital? You may have issued the shares. Okay, that is why your share have increased. So what you will do? You can write here, proceed from issue of shares, and the difference between that capital amount of both the year, you will write over here. Okay, in the amount side. Now what next? See, one more item I have tick mark, long-term borrowings. So look into the previous year. It was at the previous year, it was borrowing was 1,70,000. Now it is 2,40,000. So how, what you did? You borrowed more. When you borrowed more, more cash is coming in the business because you are borrowing the money and money is coming in the business. That's why your borrowing is increased to 2,40,000. So what you will do? Your money have raised because of that borrowing. Money raised from borrowing. The difference between those two amount have to be written over here. One, that is 70,000. So there is no more item related to financing activity. Okay. No interest on debentures, no interest on loans. Nothing is provided in the question. So restrict your entries with this much only. Add these two items. You will get 1,70,000. And so that is your cash, because the answer is in positive. So it's a cash flow from financing activity. Okay. 1,70,000. So all the three activities over. That is, you got the amount from operating activity, you got the amount from financing investing activity, and you got the amount from financing activity. That is 1,70,000. What next? The fourth part of your working note, that is net profit, net increase or decrease in cash and cash flow. So in that, what you have to do, all the three activities you have to add. That is 1,53,000. Minus 2,88,000 plus 1,70,000. What you will get? 35,000. So that is increase. If your answer is in negative, you will write cash decrease in cash and cash equivalent. But because your answer is in positive, you will write increase in cash and cash equivalent of 35,000. Okay. Next item is opening balance of cash and cash equivalent. In opening balance, there is two items which you have to write. See, cash and cash equivalent, two items will go, current investment as well as cash and cash equivalent. So opening, which is the opening current investment, 1,50,000, and opening cash and cash equivalent is 3,75,000. That two item you will add in this. See what they have done. Opening, they have added together. These two items will be added together and the result is 5,25,000. Then you have to add these two items, that is 35,000 plus opening cash and cash equivalent, you will get 5,60,000. Now what next? Closing cash and cash equivalent. So same current investment and cash equivalent, but the closing amount or the current value. So 2,40,000 and 3,20,000 is the amount. Add this together and the total result is 5,60,000. You can see your opening balance and closing balance is same. Okay, so you can further move with this same. That is, when you subtract 5,60,000 with 5,60,000, you will get 0 as your answer. 0 as your answer means your total calculation is over. So if you are getting answer as 0, that means your cash flow statement, what you have done is correct. Okay, so this is how you are supposed to do the problem related to cash flow statement. So children, today's class is almost completed. I hope you understood the way of doing the problem when there is preparation of two accounts, that is machinery account and accumulated depreciation account. So children, now it is time to conclude today's session, and we are coming to an end of accountancy online session of classes. You have to do more and more problems related to accountancy so that it get fluent. You get very fluent with the process and logic of doing the problems.